accept my request, ma'am? So you can unmute.
Yes. Now it's audible, no?
Yes. Emma, just two more minutes. Stop panikkalala. Ippa inga Zoom full
aayiruchu. Okay.
100. YouTube la people
are 100 joining. Full aayiruchu, ma'am.
100 full aayiruchu. YouTube la people have started joining. Ippa 30 appadi poiittu irukku. I think we can start now.
Okay.
Welcome. Unga staff la yaar vandirukanga nu paarra. Namma friends la yaar vandirukanga? College la irundha yaar principal vice principal
vandha konja per join pannirukanga, ma'am. Others vice principal and faculty is joined, ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah, I have told them they have joined. Few joined in Zoom link, ma'am.
Okay.
Few of the students also joined, and others they will join in YouTube link. I told Mrs. Sivagami to send the YouTube link to my vice principal so that she will forward to my students.
Okay. Angel, was it done? Angel, was the YouTube link sent to Sivagami? Angel is on call, I think. Okay. ஜாயின் பண்ணிட்டே இருக்காங்க ஆக்சுவலி யூடியூப்ல இருக்கல பிள்ளைங்க வந்துட்டே இருக்காங்க
யா வந்துருச்சு மேம் இட் தே காட் இட் சீம்ஸ் மேம் YouTube link they got it
avanga ma adala YouTube Zoom link la varrapo modhalle join panuvanga illaya
amma
yoga par unna welcome panna vendi aal innu varala okay you have the welcome ppt iruka avungitta angel te remove anyone panna nalla irukada yaariyo நல்லா இருக்காதுல யூ ஹேவ் த பிபிடி வித் யூல பட் அதுல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டூ ஸ்லைட்ஸ் வந்து அவங்க வேக்கண்டா விட்டுருந்தாங்க அவங்க ரெஸ்யூம்ல இருந்து படிக்கிற மாதிரி அது ஓகேவா உனக்கு பண்ண முடியுமா அவங்களோட எஜுகேஷனல் குவாலிஃபிகேஷன் அடிஷனல் குவாலிஃபிகேஷன் அது ரெண்டு வந்து எம்டியா இருக்கும் அது நம்ம ஸ்டாஃப் யாராவது ஒருத்தர் இது பண்ணிக்க ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் சொன்னேன் யாராவது ஒருத்தர் இது பண்ணிக்கிறாங்களான்னு கேளு உடனே டக்குன்னு சிவகாமி உள்ள வர சொல்லு
இல்லாட்டி சீன் ஜாயினா மேம்
அலர்ட்டா சீக்கிரம் வரணும் நான்லாம் ஃபாஸ்டா சீக்கிரம் வந்து
ஜாயின் யோ லதா வை யூ வாண்ட் டு லீவ்
லதா போகாதீங்க நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்பீக்கர் லதா தான் ஓபிஜி
ஆமா
She is calling you and telling her.
No, it's in chat.
Okay. Vanda. One of our faculty or students, kindly you just join in idhula pannunga. Let Sivagami ma'am join. Any of the faculty member or student, one of you, please kindly join in YouTube. Ask Sivagami to keep trying. Da vandute irukku solla varla.
So she is the community HOD, ma'am.
Amanda, avanga Shivagami.
Okay.
Then senior persons irukanga Shivagami and Uma Maheshwari rendu per irukanga. Both of them are professors.
Okay, ma'am.
So rendu professors irukanga community la namakku.
Ungaloda seithu moonu.
Abdiya na edhume department vela nu odu pandrathu. Latha edha mouna varuma iniki?
Already it is 11:15, ma'am. So okay. I hardly take 1 hour.
11:15
Okay, Lata. Okay, shall we start, Ra?
Yes, ma'am. No problem.
Okay. Start, Ra. Start welcoming.
So, yeah, she's Mr. Sivagami.
Para, you may introduce one, Raga.
And a very warm welcome to one and all present in this webinar. On behalf of GRT College of Nursing, I would like to thank the management, principal, resource person, faculty, and students for gracing this occasion. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are loving, you will be successful. The essence of great leadership is influence and not authority. With this note, I wholeheartedly welcome our beloved principal, a dynamic personality, Dr. R. Padmavati. We celebrate your leadership and you keep on influencing and inspiring us. We welcome you, ma'am. Stars shine at night. Some stars shine a bright light. It's our pleasure to welcome one such star, the eminent personality and a great academician, Dr. M. Hema Malini, principal, Hindu Mission College of Nursing, Chennai, the honorable chief guest and resource person of today's webinar. I humbly welcome you, ma'am. AHM future is hard to find, difficult to part with, and impossible to forget. With this note, I heartily welcome our beloved vice principal, Professor Chitra. We welcome you, ma'am. Leaders are made, they are not born. They are made by hard effort. With this quote, I graciously welcome our CNE coordinator, Dr. Angel Shalini, who is multi-talented and miracle worker. I welcome you, Angel. With immense pleasure of nursing, none other than members of GRT College of Nursing. I wholeheartedly welcome you all. Last but not least, may I also specially welcome our beloved students and esteemed audience of various institutions. You are strong and smart. I happily welcome you all. Once again, I welcome you all for this wonderful webinar. Thank you. So before start up with the session, I am very much privileged and pleasure to introduce our resource person of this webinar. So as you all know, Madam is principal in Hindu Mission College of Nursing. And now we will see about Madam's profile in a gist. If I started telling the whole thing, the day will not be enough. So I just made a gist of Madam's profile. So Madam has completed her career. As UG in SRM College of Nursing, PG in Homeopathy College of Nursing, PhD SRM University. And as an additional qualification, Madam has completed, next slide please. Angel, as an additional qualification, Madam has completed her PG in MSc Psychology in University of Madras and Diploma in Family Welfare Counseling, and it is from Center of Counseling, Chennai. As you all know, now Madam is presently principal in Hindu Mission College of Nursing. Next slide. Madam has various areas of expertise. So certain things we will see as a areas of expertise. So ma'am is expert in research, counseling, and organizing community programs, conducted many camps and outreach programs. And ma'am will be a resource person for various national, state level conferences and workshops. More than 13 paper presentations were done by madam, and more than 15 research papers were published by ma'am. And gist of awards and honors I'm going to tell you. So awards and honors, madam received Bharat Vidya Shiromani Award from Indian Solidarity Council, New Delhi, for conducting achievements and a remarkable role in field of education in 2019. And also she was honored in the same institution as National Mahila Ratna Gold Medal Award and recognized as Board of Study Member in Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University for the period of 2019 to 2021. And recognized as a PhD guide under Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University from 2018 April onwards. And madam has invited as a guest speaker in Vendha TV for Thinnai program on breastfeeding and child rearing in 2016. And received first prize in Power of Thoughts in English elocution during Women's Day celebration organized by SRM University in 2016. And madam has received gold medal for the paper presentation on bonding between parents and children among higher secondary school students in a Research Day celebration by SRM University in 2016. And madam has received Lifetime Achievement Doctor of Philosophy Award by ICCR in Alumni Reunion 2015 by Umayalachi College of Nursing. Received Excellence in Research Award during Teachers Day celebration by SRM College of Nursing on September 2015. And received incentive for paper publication in Scottish Indexed Impact Factor Journal during Teachers Day celebration in SRM University in 2015. Received Lifetime Achievement Doctorate Award in SRM Alumni Reunion 2015 held at SRM College of Nursing 2015. Received Best Oral Paper Award in first PhD Society Conference on the theme Revolutionized Nursing Spectrum held at Sri Ramachandra University, Porur in 2014. Awarded for Best Oral Paper Presentation in Global Public Health Conference conducted by School of Public Health, SRM University on 21st to 23rd February 2014 for the paper on prevalence of hypertension and diabetes among adults in village in Kattangulathur block. And awarded for Best Poster Presentation on the topic Contemporary Issues in Nursing organized by Chettinadu College of Nursing, Chettinadu University in 2013. So this is a small introduction about our chief guest and a resource person. With this small introduction, I would like to invite our resource person to take over the session. Thank you all.
Can I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So happy morning to one and all, those who have joined in this virtual platform. Is it audible? Yeah, yes, is it ma'am. Audible? Yeah, thank you, Mrs. Sivagami, for your warm introduction about me.
Yes,
and thank
ma'am.
You so much. And first of all, my kudos to GRT College and School of Nursing for organizing this wonderful webinar. The topic itself is very, very interesting topic. And while preparing itself, it's very interesting topic. And I think we are all in the pandemic era now. So we are all facing a lot of issues and challenges, how to retrieve the healthcare services. Again, this telehealth is a wonderful opportunity for all of us to receive the healthcare services. And we all are enjoying this telehealth services. And my sincere thanks to Principal Dr. Padmavathi ma'am for giving this wonderful opportunity to meet you all. And thank you so much, ma'am. And she's my teacher in when I was doing my MSc in Omayalachi College of Nursing. She is my teacher in Omayalachi College of Nursing. So my association with madam is long term. It's not 1 or 2 days. Right from the my PG until now, we are having continuous association. And thank you so much, ma'am, for your guidance and everything. So we are, our relationship is not like teacher and student relationship, more than that. And thank you so much. So with this, I'm moving on to the topic which is allotted to me, telehealth. So telehealth, so as I told, telehealth is a wonderful opportunity it is providing to all of us. So we'll see the meaning of telehealth and what are the various services we are accessing and how we are enjoying, what are the advantages and disadvantages of each telehealth services. Yes, slide, first slide, please. So what are the objectives of today's webinar? So after completing this webinar, so all the participants will be knowing. Yeah, next slide, please. Angel, yeah. So after completion of this webinar, so you can, I think the participants will be learning about the telehealth, the overall concept of telehealth, telemedicine, telenursing, various health apps in India, and the advantages and disadvantages, various apps and various telemedicine and telenursing in India. Next. Next slide. Yes. So you can little, yeah. So we'll move on to the introduction. So what is tele and what is health and what is telemedicine? Just we'll move on to the meaning of telehealth and telemedicine. So tele is, it's a Greek word meaning distance. Medere is a Latin word meaning to heal. So that means through distance we are healing. And telehealth is healing by wire, through network of connections. So we are healing, we are interacting with the people and we are interacting. So people think that telehealth is only the interaction between the patient and the doctors. It is not like that. So not only interaction between the patient and the doctors and the physicians, even the consultants also interact with consultants if there is any doubt, and consultants with any health team members. And many, it is a interdisciplinary approach. So any doubts, any clarification, sitting in a place, they can consult and they can provide the healthcare services. So that is the concept of telehealth. And telehealth is a potential to bridge the distance and facilitate healthcare in remote areas. Even we can reach out to the remote areas where transport facilities are not available. So even if you go to the very remote areas, the major thing of availing the healthcare services, lacuna of availing the healthcare services is transportation. Transportation is not available. That too, during this complete lockdown, transportation is completely blocked. So sitting in home, so whatever we need, whatever the healthcare advice we need, we'll be retrieving all the healthcare services through this telehealth. Next slide. So we'll move on to the history. So how this telehealth has been originated. So how it has been originated is from 1850 to 1900s. So the devices what we used was a telegraph and then radio, the connectivity through Morse code and the radio waves. So of course, previously it was only the telegraph and the radio. Radio was one of the traditional audio mode where we'll listen all the news, everything, the current updates, and the connectivity through the radio waves as well as the telegraph by the Morse code. Morse code is nothing but it is by the dots and dashes through the symbols we can able to understand the communication, the language. We can able to read it by dash and dots. So that is the traditional mode. And 1900 to 1940, the devices which they were used were radio and telephone. Connectivity, of course, by radio waves, telephone network. And then 1940 to 1970, devices like telephone and TV. So in 1940 to 70, TV was originated, and connectivity through telephone network, TV, analog transmission. And then 1970 to 2000, the devices used were telephone, TV, computer, and connectivity through TV analog transmission to satellite and internet. And 2000 to 2020, now we are enjoying all the benefits of newer gadgets. like a computer, smartphone, variety of smartphone, and then connectivity through satellite broadband services, cellular networks. So this is the facility we are enjoying it. Next slide, please. So this is the evolution of telehealth services we have originated from traditional to new. And next we'll see the various modes, how telemedicine globally, so how we have got it is from 18 previous slide. Yeah, so electric telegraph by 1844 and photo phone, just you can have a quick view, and then here telephone, and then by television in 1884, first ECG transmission in 1906, and then transatlantic wire transmission by 1901, and first exposition on telehealth care in 1924, and then digital transmission in 1949, and then the internet, which was again a great opportunity in first internet in 1969, and then globally it was launched in internet protocol in 1989. And then ISRO in India telemedicine project started in 2001. And here, if you see the NASA, again, this is also a greatest achievement globally through satellites. And then tele robotic remote surgery. Again, this was again a very important milestone in medical industry, like robotic surgeries. So this is also, this is the traditional, this is a milestone of telehealth services globally. Next slide.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, this is about, this is also, you can have a quick review. So this is about India. So previously we have seen globally, and this is the telehealth services in India. If you see, it has started in various places. ISRO, here telemedicine network, 384 rural. They have started in 384 rural hospitals and 60 tertiary care centers, and it has been started in postgraduate Institute of Medical Education and Research, AIIMS, here, and then Apollo telemedicine network in 125. They have started telemedicine nodal centers, 7 telemedicine specialty centers, and OncoNet, which has been started in Kerala. And then Narayana Hiridalaya Hospitals in 130 telemedicine centers, and Webel Kharagpur, Webel DIT and IIT. And then here ISRO, they start telemedicine application. So this is the origination, various telehealth services in India. Next slide. So again, so this is the quick view of telehealth services. How we are connecting the telehealth services from one end to the other end. So this is called as a cloud computing, which is a famous terminology every IT sector is using. So cloud computing is nothing but, so it's the transmission of and receiving of data from one end to other end through multiple channels, through multiple networks. So here hospital, through the everything through the hospital server. So if you see the personal desktop to the remote clinic, so even to the sub-center and the clinics in the very remote areas, and hospital to the tablet, and then physician to smartphone. So we are using the smartphone. From the smartphone itself, we will be connecting to the physician, and we will be clarifying all our doubts. And then through video conferencing, if any any of our reports we want to see, and then medical equipments, so anything we can able to interact. And then through the if you want any ambulance services, so that also we can connect through the video conferencing. And in the home itself, if you want to get any clarifications or any doubts regarding health conditions or preventive aspect or any curative aspect, we can connect through personal laptop. So this is called as the cloud computing, through multiple networks. So from one end to another end, we will receive data and transmit the data, and we'll have comfortable answers through the networks. Next, Angel, can you change the screen a little fast? Yeah. So this is a telehealth meaning. Okay, so now we are moving on to the topic, telehealth meaning. So telehealth generally refers to, it is a broad range of health-related services supported by telecommunications technology. So here, which includes telemedicine, health related, we can say it is health related distance learning. So it is not only we are consulting. So from expert to expert, from physician to physician, from one discipline to other health discipline. So we'll be learning many aspects. And then remote patient monitoring. So if the patient is in a remote area, through the sensors, so we'll keep the wireless body sensors in their body, and then we will be monitoring their heart rate, pulse rate, everything. So that is called as a remote patient monitoring. And through call centers, the information will be given. And consumer facing virtual e-health application, lot of e-health applications are there sitting in one place, and we can retrieve many data. And then other services that enhances the health. So anytime through the mobiles and through the various apps, we can retrieve the health information. And telehealth definition, again, the other definition is, it is defined as an use of electronic information and telecommunications technologies to support long distance clinical healthcare, patient and professional health related education, public health and health administration. So it's a concept that people having that only patient and the physician. I heard from many people that what is telehealth or telecommunication, only patient can contact the physician. So nothing else they know. So here telehealth is a broad spectrum of information. They are giving broad spectrum of information. It is a holistic dimension of, it provides holistic dimension of healthcare services. So here from the long distance, we can retrieve the health information, and the professional health related education, we can learn many things. Yeah, ma'am, anything? Yeah, telehealth definition. So again, the other definition, the various definitions I am giving. So it's a mode of delivering healthcare services and public health via information and communication technologies to facilitate the diagnosis. We'll be diagnosing, and we'll be consulting, and we'll be prescribing the treatment, and we'll educate the people, care management and self-management of a patient's healthcare while the patient is at the originating site. No need to move, no need to transport. So in the originating site, we'll be providing all the services, and the healthcare provider is at a distant site. So telehealth facilitates patient self-management and caregiver support for patients, and includes synchronous interactions and asynchronous store and forward transfers here. So one thing people should understand is, so this telehealth services, which includes synchronous and asynchronous. Synchronous is nothing but it is a live interaction through video conferencing and other mode. We'll be seeing the patient, seeing the consultant, everybody, and face-to-face interaction we'll have. And then we'll have satisfaction when we have face-to-face interaction. So asynchronous is, so already records will be recorded. All the reports will be recorded. And whenever needed, so that will be even the ECG reports and then scan reports, everything. It will be transferred to the people, those who are in request, so that they can read their reports. So that is the asynchronous. There are two types. So here next. Then next. Yeah. So the use of electronic, various definitions I'm giving, so here, which will be very useful for the audience. So the use of electronic technology or media, including live interactive audio or video, for the purpose of diagnosing or treating a patient or consulting with other healthcare providers regarding a patient diagnosis or treatment. Next. So here, what are the purposes of telehealth? So why? What are the major purposes of this telehealth is? So of course, we have seen in the previous slides, to provide clinical support. So we are providing to overcome geographical barriers. So wherever they are, so in their place itself, we are providing the services. And to use various types of information, communication technology in healthcare, even the audio mode or video mode or any records, whatever they need, we will be providing them to improve the health outcomes. So their outcome, either it may be in the preventive, curative or promotive aspects. And there are various models of care. So we'll see the various models of care: telehealth supported care, networks of networks model, consortia model, payer and employee developed model, transitional care model. So we'll see the telehealth supported care. So model. So this is the telehealth supported care. So So this is the model of connecting tertiary and quaternary healthcare facilities to other facilities in a hub and spoke model to provide specialty care services. Of course, we know what is tertiary and quaternary healthcare services. So these are all the specialized services. Actually, from the primary healthcare, they will be referring to the secondary healthcare. And if the facilities are not available, so they will be referring to the tertiary and the quaternary healthcare services. They will be providing the specialty services. So where if you need the specialty advice, the specialty consultation, so we'll be having the hub and spoke. Hub and spoke is nothing but hub is the healthcare providers and spoke is the patient or the consultants, whoever need the information. So through this hub and spoke model, we'll be providing the specialty healthcare services. So this is called as a telehealth supported care. Next. And this is the next model, networks of networks model. This is by the government organization or non-governmental or quasi-governmental organization. Actually, nowadays, now only government has started to invest finance in the all these applications. So as we are very know that Arogya Setu app, okay? So this is the app recently after this COVID pandemic, everybody is well familiar with this app. So this is... mainly now the government has taken initiative. Previously it has been done only by the private organization because they need to invest money in that if we need to provide the telehealth services. So the government organization, quasi-government, so all people have to invest in that. And next is the consortia model. So consortia model is direct from mobile users to the hospital. So whatever the services they can scrutinize the hospitals providing the services, telehealth services, and directly through the channels, they can reach the hospital and then they can avail the health services. The best example of this consortium model is the prison telehealth. So those who are in the prison, for those people, they are using this model, consortium model, to provide healthcare services to the people in the prison. And next one is the payer and the employer developed model. So here payer and the employer developed model, directly the consumers will be paying to the healthcare institutions and the health centers, those who are providing the healthcare services. So this is the direct payer and employer developed model. So from the health centers, they will be providing services to the customers. And next one is the transitional care model. So this is the model where it has been developed by the Schroeder and the Shelton. So here they are concentrating towards the target high-risk patients. Here, the target high-risk patients, which includes the patients, those who are hospitalized. So after discharge, they need to take care. So they will be, after discharge, they will be, during the hospitalization itself, they will be giving lot of education to the people. So after discharge, how they can able to do the telehealth consultation through these various modes. So that is, they'll be targeting the high-risk patients. And then follow up, especially the example we can say is people, those who are in home dialysis. So after the discharge, how they can able to take care of their health. And then follow patients. Again, after the discharge, we can follow the patients. So their health status, their prognosis, everything. And teach and coach patients about insulin, maybe self insulin demonstration. And then if they need any doubts, and then the diet consultation, everything we can teach and we can coach the patients to teleconsultation. And we can remind, encourage and assist the patients if they need any help during their home care. Next. Types of telehealth. As I said previously, it is the major classification of telehealth, live, interactive and store and forward. Live interactive is otherwise called as synchronous and store and forward is asynchronous. Next. Yeah, next. So here, live interaction. As we have seen, it is a live video conferencing, which is the two-way audio-visual. Both audio and visual will be there. It's the link between a patient and a care provider. And it is an interactive video connections that transmit information in both directions during the same time period. So I can ask questions from the opposite side. I can get the answers. And here, what are the advantages if you see the in live interaction session is enable assessment. We can do the assessment because we are seeing the patient, okay? And diagnosis and treatment in hospital or clinical settings, critical access hospitals with limited resources, they can benefit, okay? With limited resources, so those hospitals can benefit with this and improve the convenience, access, and the efficiency of care by offering walk-in telehealth services. From our place itself, we can able to interact with the people, whomever we want, the specialty services we will receive. And store and forward is asynchronous. It is, as I said previously, it is the transmission of medical images or data that takes place over a period of time and typically in separate time frames. So even one of my friend was hospitalized in the mission. So even from my home itself, I'm getting all the information, either by audio or through video, I'm getting all the information. So again, it's a very good opportunity. Even if you want to get the reports, like a scan report or CT report, so we can able to get it and we can read it. So without any doubt, so without any anybody to ask, we can read and we can interpret the findings without any doubt. And next is, next. Yeah, no need, what are the advantages? If you see, no need to travel for the practitioners and waiting times are lessened. Again, if you go and get the report, so if you give the blood sample even to the high tech or any laboratory, so they'll be telling one time and we'll be going to that laboratory and we need transport. And if we go there also, we have to stand in a queue for long period. So that everything is not there here. So waiting times are lessened and overcome the language and cultural barriers. No need to talk with the people, even whatever mother tongue you may be. So you will be getting just, you can ask and they will be giving the report. And what are the broad classification of telehealth? If you see, telehealth has been classified into telemonitoring, telemedicine, teleeducation, telenursing, teleconsultation, even administration also. So even all our colleges, we are administering sitting in the home, work from home we are doing. Even the administration also we are doing at home during this lockdown period. And tele-allied care, tele-diagnosis, tele-business, many online business during this lockdown they have started. Okay, and then tele-treatment. So from not only the allopathic treatment, all sort of treatment we are doing. And telehealth services, the broad range of telehealth services, if you see, it is the e-consults between providers, I told. From consultant to one consultant to other consultant. So if a cardiologist is having any doubt, they can refer to other person. If respiratory technologist, pulmonologist is having any doubt, they can ask the cardiologist. And then next one is the patient and the provider health education. So we can educate. Again, during this COVID pandemic, many people are educating because education is an important aspect. Even the university has taken an excellent, the MGR University has taken an excellent step, that is COVID appropriate behavior. So all the institutions under the Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University, students and staff, they are educating the public regarding the CAB, that is COVID appropriate behavior. And mobile health services, again, which is the greatest technology we are using it. And next is the remote patient monitoring. As I said, we can able to monitor the patient in the remote areas and hybrid models, combination of everything, and then store and forward. So again, that is the asynchronous mode of sending the reports, and we can interpret the reports by seeing it in the sitting in the same place. And then video-based specialty and primary care consultation and follow-up, even through video conferencing also, many experts, for example, if they are treating the COVID patient with some drugs. So if that drugs is not, what we can say, if it's not responding immediately, all the experts will sit together and they will go for the other alternative drugs. Like that only COVID one by one drug, we are inventing and we are utilizing it. Even the vaccines also, many vaccines now, by the expert discussion only it has been, we got. And then specialty consultations and follow-up visits like critical care, emergency services, pediatrics, psychiatry, radiology, neurology, surgery, primary care, dermatology, ophthalmology, cardiology, whatnot, all type of services, we can go for the specialty consultations. Next. Yeah, Angel, next. So store and forward. So again, what is this? Store and forward is a asynchronous data. So this is the asynchronous telehealth services. It's whatever the recorded data is there. So that will be sent to the telehealth service center. So there it will be reviewed by many physicians, even the ECG or echo report or the whatever the report, CT scan report, they will be reviewed. And then instructions and advice sent back to the patient along with the report. And then it has been again sent to the patient, again, we will be doing the follow-up. So this is about the store and the forward cycle. And again, this one is the remote patient monitoring. So what is, which is very, very important in telehealth services, remote patient RPM. So because those are the people where they cannot avail all the services. So those people need the services. So it has to reach the consultant services, the specialty services. It has to reach those people in the remote areas. So here by means of mobile apps and then through the smartphone phones, that is the right care in the right place and the right time. So even if they are asking any doubts, immediately it has to reach through the mobile app or through the any mode. If they are asking the questions, any doubts, the emergency, first aid measure, everything will be given through this remote patient monitoring. So here the healthcare provider will be sending the information to the physician, and physician again will be in turn reflects to the healthcare provider. So this is about the remote. What are the advantages of remote patient monitoring? If you see, it increases the care efficiency and improves access to care. So immediately, so there's no need to worry. So as we are in the remote place, how we'll get the healthcare services, like the people having the doubt. So all those doubts will not be there. So immediately they can, whatever doubt or whatever care, so they will get it. And then enable early detection of clinical deterioration. So even now the media is telling, even if you are having the sore throat or any fever, immediately we have to approach the doctor. So we should not sit in the home that it is only a normal cold or normal fever, because during this pandemic time, it is very difficult to differentiate which is a normal cold or it is because of due to COVID. Okay, so that helps in the early detection of clinical deterioration. Whether if you're going down, immediately we can approach we can ask the doctor and we can immediately take the treatment so that it will not go to the next stage of disease. And timely intervention, of course, immediately doctors will prescribe or they will give the advice or they'll give the counseling. So immediately we will get timely intervention. It prevents complications also, and it reducing the emergency department visits and hospitalization, of course. So now the government is telling that many, if our oxygen level is more than 95 or 96, no need to go to the hospital. So sitting in the in our place itself, and we can approach the doctors through teleconsultation, and we can take treatment, and we'll be in the home quarantine. So no need to go to the hospital, and we can take treatment. So that has been reduced, so that the people with critical condition, they will get bed in the hospitals. So on care of elderly or disabled, again elderly and disabled, they cannot move immediately as and when they want. So for those people, again, we can provide the telehealth services. Again, we'll see the mobile health. It is a medical and public health practices supported by mobile devices, such as phones, patient monitoring devices, and then personal digital assistants and other wireless devices. Many, many devices have come. Nowadays, in each and everybody's house, they are having the pulse oximeter and then glucometer, and then digital thermometer, because everybody is well aware that they need all the devices. So they want to check their, they want to monitor their health. Okay, so all consumers are very much that is conscious about their health. So what are the mobile health advantages? If you see, connects patients and their physicians, and it provides care for elderly patients. It helps the patients access to essential health information very quickly, and tracking the symptoms in a real time. So immediately we can track our symptoms, and then for quick diagnosis and expert feedback, and personalizing health data and treatment programs for each patient. So it is not that as a common treatment will be giving. So for each and every individual, based on the symptom, they will be giving the treatment. And here it reduces the human error, and it reduces the spread of disease and infection by conducting virtual appointments. Again, if you go to the hospital, again, we'll be very much scary. Who is COVID and who is non-COVID, where we are sitting, we'll be having a lot of fear. So that will be avoided here, because we'll be getting virtual appointments, and we'll be consulting the physician. And decreasing the hospital cost by cutting down on paper usage and wastage, because all through the networks. And then provides reminders to patients to take their medicine. So even sometimes they'll be giving reminder to you morning, afternoon, and then evening. So if, when they have to come for the follow-up, the dates, the time, everything we can set in our apps that remind us. So immediately we'll take medicine and we'll go and consult the physician. All technologies and e-consults. So So I told, no, e-consults is not only from us, from the patient to doctor alone. So here, provider to psychiatrist consultation, now we need lot of psychiatrists because everybody is sitting at home, depressed, stressed, and no need to, that is, the people are not moving out of home, they are sitting in their home and with laptops and then smartphones, everything. So now everybody is stressed. So we need, if you want any, if you want to relieve from your stress, you can consult any, many consultant services are there. So we can relieve your stress, and psychiatrist to patient virtual consult and psychiatric chart review. So if any severe depression is there, so definitely they will consult and they will talk with you, and by talking to you, they can identify what problems you are facing. And here, what are the technologies needed? We are talking about all these networks. Yes, cloud computing networks. What we need, because we need some resources. It is not that simply we can contact the physician without having any devices. So we need certain technology so that we'll have the virtual communication very comfortably with the physician and the consultants and any other disciplines. Here we need a dedicated office mobile or landline number with email ID and internet connection with all these connecting devices like integrated service, digital network, plain online telephone services, and then it is a virtual small aperture terminal. So all these are the internet connection devices, and then the hardware like desktop, laptop, computer, tablets, mobile devices, and we need the, some software in our PCs, and then digital camera, digital medical appliances, and an electronic medical record. All these we need. If we need all these things only, definitely we'll have a smoother interaction without any disturbances. And who are all the eligible practitioners, those who can involve in teleconsultation is physicians, nurse practitioners, physician assistants, nurse midwives, clinical nurse specialists, clinical psychologists, clinical social workers, registered dietitians or nutrition professionals. So whomever we need, based on the need, based on the services, we can approach any of these people and we can get the consultations. Yeah, next. Yeah, next slide. So what are the factors facilitating telehealth development? So again, development itself, it takes a long time, I think. So here, governance. What is very important is if you go and say that we need all these devices, so we want to establish a telehealth services, first we have to go and approach the even the head of the hospital, even the chairman or secretary. First we need to convince the people, so whether it is a benefit or not, how far it is benefit, so whether it is economically safer, so all those things, the administration. First we need to convince the people to use the technology. So otherwise, if you are not giving the convincing explanation to the management, people will not opt this telehealth services, even the hospitals or any other clinics or anywhere. So first, governance is very, very important. So the participation and then the administration. So everything is very, it plays a very important role in launching the telehealth services in any hospital. And then policy or strategy, it is not simply we can start the telehealth services. It is having a long-term protocol and policy. So how to start, what we need, the manpower, money, material. So how to establish, how to contact the people. So we need a separate policies and protocols and scientific development. It is not that whatever we are hearing, all the telehealth services, we can utilize it. So whether it is scientifically proven, whether it is scientifically used by everybody, whether it has been benefited. So all those things we need to see an evaluation. So how far it has been utilized, whether it is fruitful for the people, management, everybody, whether it is useful or not, we need to evaluate it. And then what are the benefits? Again, the telehealth benefit services, if you see here, it is very convenient. Of course, as we are all, I'm talking from right from telehealth services to the advantages. So it is very, very convenient if we have all the facilities in your home. So here, deliver behavioral health services from your home, office, or while traveling also. So in your office, when you are at home, and when you are traveling also, if you need any doubt, immediately you can contact. Okay, it's an opportunity for extra income. So here offer additional and non-standard appointment hours. It is not that only during the 6 to 9 only you can get the appointment. No, even midnight appointment also you can get it, because it is a telehealth services. So you'll get the, if you give consultation, you will get the extra income, those who are giving the consultation services. And it is a secure and private. So here, this is the HIPPA compliant platform is there. That means the health insurance. It is a health insurance, a portable, portability and accountability. So here, if anything goes wrong for this also, that is the insurance. So we can have the, we can get the reimbursement. Okay, here also, even people may think here will not have any reimbursement or any health insurance. Here also, it is secure and private. It is having also health insurance. And then it is very simple. Use your private computer with a camera and high-speed internet and open access to more patients, the consultants. So if you go and sit in the doctors, they are going, if they are going and sitting in the clinics, they will be only consulting within that particular time, or 50 to 100 patients or 40 to 50 patients only they can able to see. But through this many number of patients, they can have the consultation and reduce no shows or cancellation. 99.99% cancellation is not possible here, because anyhow we have reached to the consultant. Even it can be little delayed, but cancellation will not be possible. So after a few hours, they may be giving you the consultation. And next we'll coming, we'll move on to the telemedicine. Okay, so all is under one portal only: telehealth, telemedicine, telenursing. So if you see the use of medical information, the exchange from one site to another via electronic communications to improve a patient's clinical health status is called as a telemedicine. So, or exclusively medical information which is transferred, which is exchanged through the electronic communications. Next. Yeah, next. So again, it's a broad definition, the delivery of healthcare services, where distance is a critical factor by all healthcare professionals using information and communication technologies for the exchange of valid information for diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of disease and injuries, research and evaluation. Of course, it will be very useful for research and evaluation and for the continuing education to teach the healthcare providers, all in the interest of advancing the health of individuals and their communities. We are moving forward to the healthcare services. So here, as I said, telehealth and telemedicine. So here, telehealth mainly concentrating on the preventive and promotive aspects. Even now, we are all here. Before the COVID comes, we'll be taking all precautionary measures. It should not reach us. It should not come to us. Like that, we'll be consulting many people, whatever the precautionary measures, preventive measures, which we see in the WhatsApp or any mail, immediately we'll be following it to prevent the diseases. And telemedicine is especially concentrating, emphasizing much on the curative approach. After we get the disease, so how to prevent the complications and how to cure ourselves we'll be approaching. So that is called as a telemedicine. So this is the difference between the telehealth and the telemedicine. Next. So this is just a graph showing how this telemedicine market in India. So here, if you see in the 2011, it was only $100. The market was, but now it has increased to $450. So it is a vast improvement. Again, it will progress more and more, because people now, they are literally enjoying the telehealth services. Next. Next, this is the basic model of telemedicine. So what is the, how they are providing the services through the internet? So I told no. So here WBAN, it is the wireless body area network. So they'll be keeping the sensors in the body depending upon the disease condition, so that the consultants will be monitor their heart rate, pulse, and whatever the data they need with that sensor, they will be monitoring and they will be reporting to the patients. So what we need for that year, even they can go for the emergency cardiology, and panel of doctors will be discussing. It is not only that one doctor will see and they will give the report. So if they are having any doubt, there will be a panel of doctors will be discussing, and then they will be giving the, for everything, it is not everybody will be contacting the patient. So all, for all, everybody, they will be having the coordinator. The coordinator will be reporting to the patient. That is maybe a coordinator, maybe a healthcare provider. And types of telemedicine, if you see, it is the telemedicine, there are two types based on the basis of duration. on the basis of interaction. So here on the basis of, yeah, next slide. On the basis of duration, real time. So that is the live interaction, store and forward, asynchronous, and then self-testing, remote monitoring, I told. So to the remote areas, and we can teach them the self-testing measures and all, so that they can test themselves and they'll give the report. And then health expert to patient, health expert to health expert. It is not only expert to patient, expert to expert also they can contact. And here modes of communication, I told video, telemedicine facility, apps, video on chat platform, Skype, FaceTime, etc. And audio like phone, voice over internet protocol, only through voice, not through, if they are not comfortable with the video, they can get the consultation through voice over only. And then apps and text based also. So no audio, no video, text based, like through chats. So through WhatsApp and through chats, they can exchange the information. So telemedicine chat based applications, like specialized telemedicine smartphone apps, websites, other internet based systems, and general imaging, messaging, text, chat platforms, WhatsApp, Google Hangouts, Facebook, Messenger. So all those things, email and fax, this and all, text based, whatever you need immediately, you can text, you will get it back, the clarifications. And then video mode of communication, again, through video mode, telemedicine facility, and many apps are available, and video on chat and FaceTime. So many people will have comfort when they see the doctor, and then only they'll have that comfort, so that they have seen the consultant. So that gives a sense of satisfaction. Next. So it is the closest to one person in, what are the strengths of video mode of communication? If you see, it is closest to one person consultant, because we may think that doctor is near to me, okay? Because we are seeing the face of the doctor, the practitioner, and real time interaction. So whatever comes to our mind, so immediately we will talk. And patient identification is easier. Doctor can also, because without seeing the patient, sometimes he may be confused. So what is the patient name, to whom we have spoken yesterday, now whom we are talking, like that. Sometimes they may have confusion, but here it will not be there. They'll be seeing the patient in face. And then physician, nurses can see the patient and discuss, and visual clues can be perceived. Sometimes when they are complaining, so the pain, sometimes the facial expression we can able to perceive. So the pain, by seeing the patient face, whether they are in depressed or severe pain or mild pain, so that also we can able to identify. Yeah, previous life, oh yeah. An inspection of the patient can be carried out. So we can, for example, any redness or anything, the edema, if they want to see, so they can show to the physician through the video. Next. So video mode, limitations. What are the limitations if you see? So everything will have both the strengths and limitations, dependent on high quality internet connection at both ends. So of course, internet connection at both ends is very, very mandatory. Otherwise, it's very difficult to communicate. And possibility of abuse or misuse. So we know they have to, doctors, they have to follow the ethical and guidelines so that this abuse and misuse will be prevented. Sometimes it may happen. So of course, we are seeing in the media. And audio, if you see, through phone, through voiceover, and then through many apps. So this is the audio telemedicine. And then audio strengths, if you see, it's very convenient and fast. Unlimited reach. It is not that only few people we can give. So if I record it, and if I say some information, some major information, I can reach many audience. And then suitable for urgent cases, and no separate infrastructure required, nothing is required, a phone is enough. And then privacy ensured, and real-time interaction. Immediately, then and there, you can interact. That is through audio. Next. Non-verbal cues may be missed. So again, I told no. So because video is not there, only audio, so non-verbal cues may be missed. Not suitable for conditions that require a visual inspection. Yes. So if at all the doctor wants to see the skin, eye, tongue examination, physical touch is not, even seeing also is not possible here. And patient identification needs to be very much clearer. Okay, so there should not be any confusion. So these are the limitations. And text-based, if you see, specialized chat-based apps are there, smartphone apps like SMS, WhatsApp, Google Hangouts, Facebook, Messenger. Even the first standard student know very well how to use all these apps. and then text-based strengths. If you see the strengths, convenient and very quick documentation and identification may be an integral feature, suitable for urgent cases or follow-ups, no separate infrastructure required. And next. Next part. Yeah, text-based interactions also miss the verbal cues. It's very difficult to establish rapport with the patient and cannot be sure of the identity of the healthcare providers or the patient. And asynchronous, it's through email, fax, recordings, and voice over internet protocol and SMS. So already it has been dealt. And strengths, if you see, it's very convenient and easy. No specific app or download required. Images, data, reports, even the lab reports immediately shared. Even now, how we are getting all our COVID report result through app only and through our WhatsApp only from the lab, they are sending to us. Immediately, we will be seeing whether it is mild, moderate or severe. We will interpret. And no separate infrastructure, and more useful when accompanied by the test reports and follow-up and second opinions. So even if it will be very useful if it having the opinions from the doctors. And it's not a real-time interaction limitations, if you see. And patient identification, again, repeatedly I'm saying, the patient identification is document-based only and difficult to confirm. And non-verbal cues are missed. And sometimes here it is missing, there may be delay in seeing the charts. Okay. Sometimes you may be sending, but they may not be seeing immediately. Sometimes there will be a delay in seeing your emails or Google charts or chats, messenger chats. And then, which has been supported by many. So here, Indian Space Research Organization, NEC Telemedicine Program for Northeastern States, Apollo Hospital, Asia Heart Foundation, state governments, telemedicine technology also supported by many private organizations also. Next, telemedicine softwares in India. So if you see, many softwares are available. Many we know, many it is there, and many people are using some health services. Many people are not aware of some health softwares. The MD Live and Lemonade, Live Health, Plush Care, Doctor on Demand, Amwell, Talkspace, Teladoc. So these are all the softwares which is available. And the element specific to telemedicine is appropriateness of telemedicine, identification of registered medical practitioner and the patient, appropriateness of technology and mode of telemedicine, patient consent. So we need to get the patient consent, and patient evaluation is essential, and patient management, health education, counseling, and medication. So these are all the very important elements. And benefits of telemedicine is, yes, next slide. Yeah. So for patients, for various categories, what are the benefits? You see, immediate access to healthcare specialists, convenience to the patient, it saves time traveling, no need to take leave from work. So if you want to go to the hospital, consult the doctor, we'll be applying CL, EL, and then we'll be moving. But no need to take CL, EL. Even in your office itself, you can consult your doctor. Good patient engagement and improved quality of care delivery is very cost effective and good for immunity. That is, fewer chances to catch an infection from the hospital visit. Okay, no nosocomial infection. And then better decision making for the service providers. So what are the benefits for the service providers? Analysis of stored data increases the practice efficiency. Better follow-up of a patient can get a second opinion immediately for better diagnosis and management. If you are not convinced with one doctor, so immediately you can get an appointment from other doctor, and you can get the second opinion, third opinion also. Some people will not convince even after second opinion, third opinion also. They'll be keep on moving to the many opinions, and finally they will come to a conclusion whether which consultant they need to go for consultation. And revenue is increased by reaching many patients. By hospitals will be, service providers will be, we need to convince the management. So how come we can able to generate the revenue? Then only people will accept in the management. And it saves time. A physician can see many patients, can make informed decisions if the in-clinic visit is required or not. Yeah, next is, next slide. Applications of telemedicine in India. So for what are the things we are using this telemedicine? If you see home care and ambulatory monitoring. So for home care and ambulatory, communication between health providers separated by distance, and critical care monitoring where it is not possible to transfer the patient, even everything, even train itself. People move the patient with a ventilator in the train itself. And then continuing medical education and clinical research. A tool for public awareness. So of course, it's a major to lot of information through WhatsApp and other chat base we are getting. They are creating a public awareness. And then a tool for disaster management if any untoward situation arises. So to manage that particular disaster, so to reach out to millions of people, so this will be very, very useful. And telementored procedure surgery using the hand robots. Again, so that is also a major robotic medicine is plays a very important role nowadays. And disease surveillance and program tracking. So we can monitor the diseases, and also we can track what program is going on in which place. Challenges of telemedicine in India, of course, if you do something new, there will be a lot of challenges. So perspective of medical practitioners, again, the doctors or the medical practitioners, those who have completed their training long back, for those people, it will be very difficult to adapt to the current modalities, okay? So for those people, we need to give training. So how to give consultation, how to do the live interaction, how to do the chat-based everything. Still, people are not updated. So for those people, at least we need to give little training. And then patients' fear and unfamiliarity. So now people will be having, most of the people are familiar with the technology, how to use, but still few people in the remote areas, they are having fear and they don't know how to use the technology. And financial unavailability, it is not that simply because they will give the consultant services, right? So we need to pay money. So they will be having financial constraints also. And lack of basic amenities. Of course, they need the laptop, mobile phones, and then desktop, everything, internet connections, everything. So if it is not there, then again, it will be a big challenge. And literacy rate and diversity in languages. Of course, we need to read that. To interpret the findings, we need to know how to read it. Language and literacy is very important. And then technical constraints. Of course, how to use, even if we are having all the resources. So we need to have training how to use that resources technology. And then quality aspect. Sometimes how far the qualities we are receiving is very important. And then government support. So we need a government support also. Nowadays during this COVID pandemic, the government support is very, very enormous in telehealth services. And now we are coming to the nursing professionals, tele-nursing. So again, which is also flourished in nursing, also this telehealth services, that we can call it as a tele-nursing. So the use of telecommunications technology in nursing to enhance the patient care, it involves the use of electromagnetic channels. Of course, the same thing, the wire, radio, and the optical to transmit voice, data, and video communication signals, which is given by the International Council of Nurses. Okay, what are the guidelines for tele-nursing practice here is, we need context. So what we are going to deliver? Identification of the registered nurse and the patient, which registered nurse is giving the consultation. So that we need to identify the mode of communication, which either you can go for the asynchronous or synchronous, which is comfortable, that we need to assess. And we have to get the consent, assessment and communication, and then we'll be managing the patients. And then we are having the professional accountability. At any cost, we should not give any wrong information. We have to give the that is factual information to the patients. That is very much important. And purposes of telenursing, to increase the accuracy of nursing documentation and to provide quality care to the needy. So those who are in the very remote areas, so of course we can give them the quality care. To improve the workflow of nurses in patient care, to support patient, nurses and care providers in decision making and role setting. So in case if any emergency situation, if at all we need to take any decision, so at that time we can have a meeting and then we can have a decision. And to facilitate in the analysis of clinical data. So how to interpret the findings. So that also very important. And what are the duties and responsibilities of physician or a nurse? Medical ethics. We need to strictly follow the ethics. So there should not be any negligence. There should not be any malpractice. So either audio dane, video dane, there should not be any negligence or malpractice. And data privacy should be there. It should not be known to others. And confidentiality should be maintained. And documentation and digital records of consultation should be there. Though we are giving consultation, it should be digitally recorded for future use and fee for telemedicine. And then so the application is home care, we'll be using this. And then telephone triage. Even in telephone also, we can follow the triaging protocols and case management. So which is very essential. Next. So what are the benefits for nurses of tele-nursing is flexible working hours, It is not only the 8 hours duty or morning shift, evening shift or night shift. So anytime, improved salary, less travel, cost effectiveness. So people have the job satisfaction, opportunity for skill development, rapid response time and data sharing. So we can discuss with our other colleagues and we can get, in case of any doubt, we can make a decision. So for the patients, it's easy access, economical. Sometimes it will be very economical, reducing the transportation time, everything. And then high quality care, patient satisfaction, remote services also we can able to look into. Less travel, no waiting queues, convenient, and it is very simple. Next. Next. Disadvantages, unable to see the patient. Ethical dilemmas will be there. And technological difficulties will be there. Less human contact and privacy, security, and confidentiality concerns. Sometimes by without our knowledge, we'll be sharing the patient information to others. That should not be done. And high cost of equipment, lack of proper knowledge. So before we give information, please, they have to train themselves. And all the doubts should be clarified. Then only they have to give the teleconsultations. And mishandling of conversation. And patient safety issues is very much important. Delayed or missing information, sometimes if they are not reachable, sometimes the missing information or delayed information will be there. Misunderstood advice. So whatever I'm giving the advice, sometimes it will be misunderstood by the patient. And legal and ethical issues, if you seek maintaining a client's privacy, so only one-to-one consultation should be there. It is not that after time I can give the same type of cases. So I can give two consultation to two people at a time. That should not be done. So we should give due respect to the patient. So privacy should be maintained, and we have to prevent the malpractice and maintaining a client's security, maintaining client's autonomy, confidentiality, client's integrity. Again, it should not be revealed to others. Harm, no harm to the patient. Reimbursement issues, again, by means of any insurance, and verifying the consent. So whether they have given the consent or not, we need to check. Telehealth in India, if you see what are the apps and other services in India, we are in use now. Yes, next. So it's e-Sanjeevani. It is major services, the telehealth services e-Sanjeevani is giving, right from the OPD to all the specialty services. Next. So you can log into this website and you can see a lot of services which has been given by the e-Sanjeevani. It is India's telemedicine service. It's more than 1 million consultations, and through long distance consultations, lot of essential care services they are providing. Next. So just you can log into this. And here you can see it's a national teleconsultation services. So all the teleconsultation doctors attending the patient, and there is a protocol. So how to consult the doctor through online itself. So you have to log in and you have to get the token, and then you have to pay the fees, and then you in the online, you have to wait, and then you have to consult the doctor. Okay, next. So this is the online OPD services, real-time telemedicine, and then they are providing the state services, and then video consultation, chat, and they're also providing free services. So this is the steps to consult the doctor. Verify your mobile number through that app, and then you have to generate the token after registering, login, and after getting the notification, wait for your turn, and then you can download. After consultation of the doctor, you can download your e-prescription. Again, this is the e-Sanjeevani mobile app. So then and there, you can consult the doctors whenever you need any emergency services. Okay, next. So next is the Ayush Sanjeevani app. So this is also the app. So related to Ayush, if at all you want to consult any doctors, you can log into this app and you can consult the physician. You can get any information. Next. Namaste Yoga app. So this is also another app. You can log into that. So if you want to meet any physicians and then any protocols, you can get it. And this is the website. You can go through this mobile health national portal website. You can log into that. And then related to any health queries, so you can get the details here. So top 10 mobile apps registered in National Health Portal is AIMS, WHO, CCNVAC, and then Healthy UCAR, Healthy UR, 1MG, mHealth Basics, Safe Pregnancy and Birth, the mHealth Planning and Implementation Guide, Mobile Technology for Water Sanitation and Health, and then MESPIA, CDAC, and Frontline SMS. So these are all the top 10 mobile apps, and the mobile apps most popular, which ranks 5 out of 4 in India, is Practo, mFind, DocApp, 1MG, NetMeds, Librit, MediBuddy, and MedLife. So these are all the popular apps, which is very ranked among 5 out of 4. You can log into any app and you can get the details. And again, the other apps developed to trace the contacts. Everybody very well know this Arogya Setu app. Okay, contact tracing. And we can also, check ourselves whether we are having any symptoms. And then Go Corona Go. So this is also app for contact tracing and quarantine. So this is also app for tracing the COVID symptoms. And teleconsultation during COVID. Again, this National Rural Health Mission also, you can log into that and you can get the teleconsultation. Next. Health institutions offering telemedicine during COVID. Of course, this you might have seen in many WhatsApp groups. Yes. So which are all the hospitals providing the teleconsultation and in Chennai and other places. And also they have given the contact numbers. Okay, like Apollo Hospital, Ramchandra, Shankar Netralia, and then many hospitals, Morgan Diabetes. So you can contact them. So these are all the services the government has taken, and also the private hospitals has taken initiative in providing the teleconsultation services. If you see the advantages and disadvantages of the telemedicine during COVID-19, so if you see here, the facilitators will be the ASHA's primary health center, village resource centers. So we are providing the holistic care through telemedicine, through the specialty consultant by means of teleradiology and tele-laboratory services. So here, what are the advantages? If you see, it's a time-saving, easy. Yeah, it's a time-saving, easy accessibility, social distancing, triage, first aid, and then we can refill the prescriptions again and again. We can go and we can do the follow-up, and then cost-effective, reduces the overcrowding, health education is possible here. But if you see the disadvantages, technological issues, lack of physical examination, we cannot able to see the patient, how far the symptoms have been deteriorated, and missed diagnosis. Sometimes patient literacy plays a very important role. Medico-legal issues are there, prescription errors sometimes may be there, and prescription honored by the chemist. So here what even the pharmacist will prescribe. Nowadays, everybody is going and getting medicines from the pharmacy. Sometimes the pharmacist will not give medicine unless and until you give the prescription. Okay, so that will be there. The prescription honor by chemist is there, and confidentiality sometimes will not be maintained here. These are all the disadvantages. So if you see, in conclusion, telehealth is a gift in reality. It is a bridge to the provider and the patient. With advancements in technology, there will be an appropriate growth in telehealth too. So it's not, we cannot say that 100% we have entered into the telehealth, but slowly people should understand, they have to enjoy the services. Then it will be a big boon to the healthcare community. And thank you so much for your patient listening. I hope I've done justice to the topic. So any doubts, any clarifications, audience can reach me.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
So I think 1 hour.
Thank you. Hemas, excellent it was actually. MCH la so many apps are also there, mother and child tracking.
Yeah, okay,
ma'am. Apps are there. Now it is rural health la so many mobile apps have come that is practically people are using it actually. Okay, so one thing I want to clarify is that government services telehealth are they charging? Is it free or charging? You said some pay, you have to pay in one area. Private,
that is private institutions, ma'am. Government institution, I think no need to pay.
And a government app,
I think so.
NRHM, la, the Munadi government of Minister of Health and Family Welfare, when you are showing, you said that payment has to be done. Whether I think is it's free. Government consultation, it is completely free. And shall I add on to your topic?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Sure.
This telehealth concept first in India came during the Kargil war and other times actually. Especially during that time only for the soldiers, to give the healthcare service to the soldiers, it was started actually. Now still it is there, especially in the areas of your Chardham. You know that, Rishikesh, Haridwar and your Gangotri, Yamunotri and Badrinath, all these areas, it is very difficult. The 6 months, the whole area will be completely, it will be freezed. Only 6 months it will be open for the darshan of the thing. But in those areas also, during those time also, the army people are there to clean and other things and all. So they, most of the time, North India, this telehealth services is very, very famous.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Most of the people are using only telehealth services. It is very famous and it is very reachable to the company public also. And I have the experience of teleconsultation.
Okay, ma'am.
Consultation for my father actually, who was suffering with dementia. So we had a tele. It is not just simply consultation. It takes a long process actually. We have to register and we have to initiate the payment initially first in the private level. We have to initiate the payment first. And after the payment, it is just not there. Just like that they come and see the patient. Within just 2 to 3 days prior itself, every stage by stage history collection is there actually. They collect history from all the people and they collect all the medical reports and other things if it is there and all the details. And finally, they see the patients and they collect the history and they even do something also, if they're able to do this or this. With a good educated, literate people are there, means they...
Yeah, it is not easy that everybody can give teleconsultation. Yes. And they have to undergo a lot of training.
Especially in psychiatric, they do wonderfully, actually. And after that, they do the follow-up also. Yes. They order some investigations and they ask us to send the reports to them, all those things. Scan and all, CT scan and all, how it should be sent, that I couldn't get to Hema.
The
how
report, was... ma'am. The report alone.
Report alone can be sent.
Yeah, report alone can be sent.
The image is how they cannot see the image and all.
The image also, ma'am, by through WhatsApp messages and other things, color images, they can send. Through a PDF file, if they send, they can able to see and interpret.
That we cannot do, I think. Only the technicians can send.
Technicians can send to the healthcare providers. The healthcare providers will be sending to the patient.
Okay.
On request.
Okay. That was really interesting, actually. Any doubts now? Anybody, if you raise your hands or you can type your questions in the chat box. If you raise your hands, we can unmute you and you can speak actually. So it was a powerful presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
You can, Angel, please kindly unmute Dr. Lata. Dr. K. Lata is there. Let her give the feedback for our friend's presentation. After that... somebody is watching YouTube. Like somebody can watch.
Krishna
Pujistar. Evradi?
Ma'am, this is Lata.
Yeah, Lata. Good afternoon.
Hey, Lata.
Thank you, ma'am.
Nice to see you. Sorry, nice to hear you.
sorry. I'm not actually well, ma'am. That's why I just put myself I didn't project myself. So I, and as usual, I was conveying my husband since 15 years. No, I had been in association, not 15 years, more than 20 years in association with Hema. I said, not even a single tone she has changed. So I appreciate her wonderful, wonderful power. It was like listening to a seminar as we did in our PG. So, it was a wonderful presentation.
And the same feeling also I got, the same feeling being a departmental HOD, how she used to present her seminars, the same way I was listening actually.
So till now she's with full of energy and power-packed presentation, involvement. So all these have not changed within her. So I'm so happy to listen to her. And it's rightly said, this telehealth is of a great important topic to the people in this pandemic. You know, few of us really into the depression, this COVID pandemic, this affected differently, different people in different way. So absolutely the telehealth topic would be a real idea so that people would have got them. So all the nurses who attended this program can share about the available apps and the health and the utilization of these apps are really important. So we have come to know about these apps, but the real practice of utilizing in our day-to-day practice is quite a challenging one. So with the extent of nurses' support reaching to the common public about these apps, sure, the telehealth would be really a successful one.
But so recently the usage is very high, Lata, actually.
Yes, ma'am.
Earlier it was only, it was very famous with only with the North Indian people, actually. But nowadays everywhere it is started. Even a doctor, one of our doctor, devoted doctor, he is a diabetologist. He also said, when I call, he said, Madam Mataji, I'm in consultation, online consultation. The person who has the clinic also, they have their own set of people, no? Who will see the, him only, the family physician only, they will see. Such kind of people, not only the hospitals, what the HEMA, you listed some hospitals, no?
Yes.
Not only them. Nowadays, even the small clinicians, small clinic doctors also, they have started doing the telehealth. Most of the hospitals in Chennai, almost all the hospitals in Chennai, they started doing the telehealth consultation.
That would be a real fruitful experience. If this all works out very well, people would be really benefited, ma'am.
Yes.
So thank you for such a wonderful topic. We've been happy listening to a wonderful topic presented by Mrs. Hema Malini and the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you, Lata.
Thank you, Padma.
Thank you, dear. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay. One more thing also in this telehealth you have to see is telemedicine. She has told actually, telemedicine is, it is only a consultation. As Hema said, it is only a curative services. But telehealth services is not restricted to only curative services. As she said, it is for preventive. And also, not only the preventive, nowadays, now the pandemic has created administration training also. Training part. You can train the healthcare professionals. Now, the doctors are given training. Even INC also gives a lot of training to training package. So, almost all that is administration, training, education. Everything is done with
the. So I think INC has given a lot in MCH training. MCH training.
MCH training and COVID awareness training also. Nowadays, the standard guidelines, standard operating SOP, standard operating procedures are given to the doctors from the WHO through this mode only, actually. Nowadays, Zoom is famous, actually. So many apps are there, actually. We have our Google Meet is there, Cisco. Is there so many things there, but Google is famous. The government uses mostly Zoom for giving training to the various kind of healthcare personals also, especially the training of the doctors, training of the nurses. It is also done by the telehealth only. That is the reason we say it is a telehealth services. I think telenursing is not yet famous with the India, actually. Still.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
It is mostly followed.
Again, nurses have to get trained in that aspect.
Yes,
and nobody has come forward for this.
Telehealth is working on well and telemedicine is working on well, but telenursing, I think still it has to develop for nursing part of you. In India, it is limited only, actually, but in abroad countries, telenursing is more famous than your telehealth and telemedicine. Now only they started doing this, all this thing, training, I think.
Our people are not giving due respect to nurses, man. That's why. Nurses have to be given due respect. Genuinely, people will come forward.
Any questions in the chat box? Good afternoon, ma'am. It was an amazing presentation. Madam has given very vast information. My father also was telling, actually, my father is became violent. He is suffering with dementia. I couldn't control him, so I made him to sat with him. And he was telling, Amma, this madam is speaking a lot, actually. She's speaking vast information about telehealth. Thank you, ma'am, for arranging wonderful. It is very useful. Any questions related to this? Comments are there, feedbacks are there. Questions? YouTube, Angel, YouTube, any questions there?
No, ma'am.
No, okay. Now everybody is expert with the telehealth, presentation, awesome deliberation. Dr. Raja T. Saktivel.
She is the vice principal, ma'am, of our college.
Unmute panni vidungla.
Okay. Raja T.
Dr. Raja T. Saktivel. Finally, unmute, Angel. Number VP ma'am kuda unmute panni vidra.
Yes, ma'am.
Then Uma Maheshwari, you are unmute.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon,
ma'am. Hearty congratulations for you, ma'am, for arranging the wonderful webinar as a need-based webinar in this pandemic situation.
Okay.
And madam is a resource person. Really, it's a double bounce for us. Really, we are very happy to be here with the presentation and being a resource person of our college, ma'am. And really, it's very happy to seeing all in this forum, ma'am. And really, ma'am, was session was really very informative. And more or less, this is the eye-opening session for all the novice nurses.
Yes,
become,
yes.
They will become and disseminate to every each and every family members to reach in this pandemic situation. So definitely, it will be a boom for our students.
Yes.
To control and reduce these pandemic issues. Really, we are very happy to be a part of this webinar, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
And congratulations to our principal, ma'am, for giving the excellent and awesome deliberations regarding the content. The vast content,
you.
Even though the vast content is there, she has completed in the particular timings. And really, it is, we too thought that whether it will be extended the particular timing, the respective timings, but she has completed within the time period. Really, it's amazing, ma'am. Thank you so much for the deliberation.
Thank you, Rajati.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. And thanks for all the organizers given the opportunity for me, ma'am.
Thank you. Yes. Anybody else you would like to say? VP ma'am, unmute pandra. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you remember me, ma'am?
Yeah, I remember you. I told Padmavati, ma'am, also. I know you.
How are you, ma'am? After a long time meeting you.
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
Very fine, ma'am. Very fine.
Yeah.
Ma'am, really a wonderful presentation. Because this is a needed as, madam has given the topic as a needed hour topic. Really, it is a very important topic, and definitely our events, most every, all the students, they will be having quite information about this, and also your vast information, in-depth information, I can say. In-depth information, surely, definitely, it will be helpful for the students also, ma'am. And still, I remember every time if I get that question paper set up from SRM, I used to think about you.
Yeah.
And also
we had an association when I was working in SRM, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So once I have seen your name, because I may not be knowing that you are the principal in Hindu mission. So once I saw the invitation only, I came to know really, I was very, very happy, ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much.
And really awesome and wonderful presentation, because the students, they might be knowing, but they may not be knowing that apps and all, presently what we are having and the government, what they are implementing. So this surely, definitely, it will be helpful for the students. Thank you, ma'am. And also, my heartfelt thanks to my principal, ma'am, because every time she used to think in different way. So what sort of, how we can engage our faculty members, what are all the inputs, in which way we can make them to be informative. So I thank you, ma'am, for arranging this webinar, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Also, I'm happy to be part of this webinar. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Any other questions? Any questions from YouTube? Nirmala, are you watching in YouTube?
No, only feedback, ma'am.
Feedbacks only. Okay.
Some people, they have asked a PPT, ma'am. If they need, you can send it, ma'am. No problem.
Okay, da.
So it is for the students' benefit only. So those who are requesting, you can send it, ma'am.
You can see the nice, they have given nice feedbacks in the YouTube also.
Yes, ma'am.
You can see it actually. So much feedback. So shall we wind up, Hema?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for the organizers. Wonderfully organized and without any problem. And thank you so much for giving opportunity to you, ma'am.
All the credit goes to our CNE coordinator.
Yeah, of course. The entire team of GRT CNE team. Yeah, very well organized.
Till this technically, she is very well versed.
Okay. Now we need a technically expert only.
last year, we used to have all technical people, engineering from people.
Okay.
Someone help us.
Now, ma'am, nowadays nurses, they learn technical aspects also. It is not that. So what not we need to learn. Everything also we are learning.
She has learned a lot, how to generate a certificate also, everything she does.
Yeah, of course, that's very happy.
So maybe our first engineer she is.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Before vote of thanks, I would like to say, as Dr. Lata informed, that the not even single pitch also changed. How I say my maybe the two which batch you are in 2005, right?
2005 I completed, ma'am.
2003 to 5.
Mm.
So it was she was my first student. I completed in 2003 and
yes.
So we used to have a nice time actually, community, especially. We were like friends only, not like a student teacher.
Yeah, of course, ma'am.
We enjoyed a lot because our teacher, our especially I would like to thank our madam, Dr. Mahesh Jaikumar madam.
Yeah.
In a cooking demonstration kuda pakkathula okkandhe ellathiyum mathavadi panna kudadhu idu kai epdi cut panna kudadhu solli kuduthu chinna chinna vishayangala pannuvaanga. The same style we also followed with our students, and still even now also today we are like friends only, we are not like we maintain a good relationship. The Hemana vandu, she will be always exceeding my expectations. Whatever presentation I have gone, your presentations for trends and issues, and also a lot of community seminars and research project corrections, adala vandu I always admire her. She has always exceeded her expectations. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Our invitation and gracing this occasion. I think Angel Shivagami has raised her hands. Kindly unmute her. She would like to say some feedback. Or
ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Ma'am, it's really an amazing presentation, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you.
Presently needed a topic, ma'am. So many of them have doubts in this, whether we have to follow this. Okay, said ma'am.
Thank you, Shiva. Thank you so much,
ma'am.
Thank you, Shivami. Thank you so much.
Education, ma'am. Slowly and slowly, you have cleared your content, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, that's all.
Yes,
okay. Uma Maheshwari.
Yes, ma'am.
You are doing the vote of thanks, Ilya. Yeah?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
She's one more professor. I said.
Okay, ma'am.
We have Uma Maheshwari is Professor Uma Maheshwari from Community Health Research Department. She will be proposing vote of thanks. Kindly proceed, Uma Maheshwari.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of GRT College of Nursing and School of Nursing, I take this opportunity to extend a heartfelt gratitude to the participants for gracing this webinar. First of all, I would like to thank our God Almighty for his blessings and grace for making this webinar a great success. I must mention our deep sense of gratitude and sincere thanks to our management for the support in organizing this webinar. My very special thanks to our resource person, Dr. M. Hema Malini, Principal, Hindu Mission College of Nursing, for her more vivid, lively, eloquent speech. This outbreak of COVID-19 has pushed the healthcare providers to accelerate the integration of telehealth into medical care. And ma'am rightly stressed and talked about the benefits of telehealth in the healthcare system. Thank you for your valuable speech, ma'am.
Thank you.
It's a matter of immense pride for me to convey my gratitude to our beloved principal, Dr. Padmavati R, because ma'am, you are giving tireless support and guidance to organize the needed webinar during this pandemic. Thank you so much, ma'am. My special and hearty thanks to all the delegates from various institutions, faculty members, and students for their active participation, support, and dedication throughout this webinar. Next, I would like to convey my gratitude to our Vice Principal, Organizing Secretary, and my dear faculty members for your constant support and guidance. Last but not least, my sincere thanks to all the students of GRT College of Nursing and School of Nursing who had actively participated in this webinar. Thank you all. I once again thank one and all for your patience and kind cooperation. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. All the students and the faculty members, whomever has not subscribed our YouTube channel, kindly subscribe. Money ella illa adukku. Just subscribe. Just kudukuna or bell button raise panna. You will get free forthcoming seminars, websites, the uploads irundhuchina. It will reach you all. Ungalku pop up aagum, so you can see easily. So that is the reason. Kindly, so whenever you see your YouTube, kindly subscribe to the YouTube channel. Okay. Thank you all. Thank you, Hema. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
So all the faculty members who have come from outside, Dr. Lata and Dr. Rajati, Vila, Ilamati, I think they are new. Thank you, thank you, dear. Thank you so much. We'll wind
thank
up.
You.
Thank you, Shivan. Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you.
Welcome.
மாம் இதுல எந்த மீட்டிங் மாம் மாம்
ரஜிதா
எஸ் மாம் நான் ஹோஸ்டா இருக்கே அதான் மாம் கேக்குறேன் சில எந்த மீட்டிங் மாம்
அப்படியா இது ஏஞ்சல் கிட்டீங்களா
மாம் எனக்கு சேஞ்ச் பண்ணி விட்டுட்டாங்க மாம் மாம் இல்ல மாம்
சரி ஓகே அப்போ இது பண்ணிடு மேம் பண்ணிடுங்க
எஸ் மாம்
நான் லீவ் ஆயிட்டேன்
எஸ் மாம்
ஓகே